Hello everyone, welcome to Happy Cooking World. Today's recipe is homemade garlic bread with herbs. So let's see what are the ingredients. The ingredients list can also be found below my video and also in my blog. The blog link is given below the video. So to start with the recipe, I have here 1 teaspoon of sugar and 1 1/4 teaspoon of active dry yeast, to which I added 1 cup of lukewarm water, and then I will stir it and keep this aside. The other ingredients are 3 cups of all-purpose flour or maida, and you will also need more flour for dusting. And here I have 1 1/4 teaspoon of salt, or use it as per your taste, 1/2 teaspoon of garlic powder, 1 1/2 teaspoon of dried rosemary, and 1/2 teaspoon of dried thyme. And these are my measuring cup and measuring teaspoon. Now we will start the kneading process. Into the all-purpose flour, I added the dry ingredients, mixed it with my hands. Then I made a well in the center, into which I will pour the yeast mixture, which is now activated. Now I will start kneading it, and I want a sticky dough, so slowly I'm going to incorporate the flour into the dough. And now you can see the flour is incorporated. I'm adding one more, that is around 1/2 cup of normal water, and I am going to knead it in this texture. This is the texture I want. And then after this, I added 1 teaspoon of olive oil, and I am slowly spreading the olive oil on the kneaded flour. This I will keep it in the oven, covered in the oven with only the oven light on, not the oven on, for minimum of 3 hours. You can also keep it in any other place, any warm place. And in the meantime, I'm going to make the garlic oil, garlic and rosemary oil, for which I took 2 tablespoons of olive oil. When it is heated, I added the garlic, and then when the garlic is light brown in color, I will switch off the flame, and I will add 1 teaspoon rosemary. If you don't have rosemary, you can add any Italian spice mix. Now after 3 hours, you can see the dough has risen. Then I'm going to scrape out the dough into the dusted flour surface, and after this I will gently punch and fold the dough several times. And when you're doing this, you can see the dough is very sticky, so keep on dusting flour on the surface of the dough so that it is easy for you to work with the dough. You can see now the dough is done, it is spread, and I have added flour, and on it I will spread the garlic rosemary oil. So I'm starting to spread the oil on it. And after I have spread the oil, I'm going, just like you stuff the paratha, you make the stuffed paratha, in that way I'm just going to fold the dough from all sides. And once it is folded, I'm going to show you how it looks. And for this also, if you need, you keep on dusting more flour on it. You can see I have folded the dough from all sides, and now what I will do, I will turn the sealed surface underneath, I will turn it upside down. So slowly raise the dough and just turn it on the other side. After I turn it on the other side, now I will again cover it, and this time on the countertop I will rest it. This I have turned it, and now on the countertop I will rest it let it rise for another 2 hours. When the dough is rising, you can see that after 2 hours the dough has risen. Now I am going to preheat my oven to 450 degree Fahrenheit, which is around 236 degrees Celsius. So you preheat the oven, and into the oven I will put this oven proof iron skillet, which I covered with a foil. Since I do not have a Dutch oven, I am using this technique where I have greased the oven proof iron skillet with oil. If you are baking, if you are using baking sheet, You do not need to do this step of preheating the sheet also, but since it is an iron skillet, so when I'm preheating the oven, I will put the iron skillet inside it so that it also takes the temperature of the oven. Then be careful while you take out from the oven, because it will be hot, so use your gloves, which is oven proof gloves, and slowly take out the skillet. And I'm going to slide this dough into the skillet gently and carefully, and after this I'm going to put the dough to bake in the oven at 450 degree Fahrenheit, which is roughly 232 to 236 degrees Celsius, covered 30 minutes and uncovered 20 minutes. So now I'm going to cover it with the aluminium foil. Since it is very hot, be very careful while you stick the aluminium cover on it. You can use oven proof gloves at this stage. And after covering it properly, I'm going to put it into the preheated oven of 450 degree Fahrenheit, which is 236 degrees Celsius. Covered, I will bake for 30 minutes. Then I will take off the cover. You can also use oven proof lid. I do not have it, so I'm using this aluminium foil. And 20 minutes uncovered. Now, after 30 minutes, you remove the foil and you check. Since oven differs, the timing may vary a little bit. So the bread is ready. Enjoy your bread, and please, if you like the recipe, please share with your family and friends and subscribe to my channel. See you again with some other recipes, and till then, all of you stay happy, stay healthy, and goodbye. Thank you.